Here we go. Wow.
He hurt him with that hook.
Oh, very nice.
Now closes the distance.
And now he's got that tie clinch. We'll see what he can do with it.
Another shot lands upstairs.
Didn't quite connect.
St. Preux gets caught with that punch. So his opponent lands that kick to the body, Joe, and he has shown an increased susceptibility to that strike here tonight.
Now he's got the Muay Thai block.
Oh, he missed that kick.
OSP gets caught with that punch. Got to shore up the defense here. Some nice back and forth action here.
Good job there of avoiding the clinch.
Oh! He's got him hurt here.
Just missed with a huge kick.
Takedown attempts starting to pile up.
Ooh, and he caught the kick.
Wow, that takedown shook the canvas, Joe. Beautiful job to catch the leg and get this fight to the ground. You gotta think that made an impression on the judges sitting octagon side here
tonight.
He's
landing some serious ground and pound strikes here.
Liddell gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Joey ups for the knee to the body inside control, and that one lands. Posture's up here, and now going to the body with that big strike. Nicely done by St. Preux.
Still working this ground and pound. Good punches.
90 seconds to go in round one.
Into half guard again. Side control, tying up that arm, looking for the Kimura. He's got his arm pinned down. He's got that Kimura locked up. He popped out of the Kimura. Oh, elbow to the head.
Pound and pound elbow starting to pile up now by St. Preux.
He's got a Kimura. He's got his arm pinned down.
Got a very good Kimura.
He might get a finish here.
That Kimura was nasty, but he got free.
Horn sounds for the end of round one. Let's get to round two.
Starting off this round, you gotta think he's probably still hurt from that last round. He's gonna wanna move and avoid taking damage early. Chuck has a very interesting style as a powerful striker in that he likes to move away. He likes to have guys come after him and then catch them coming in.
Well, Joey seems to have his opponent's timing down. He has landed some good shots, but nothing really in terms of multi-shot combinations, and perhaps that's why his opponent's still standing. So perhaps at this point, he could change up the power with which he throws some of these strikes, maybe alter the tempo a little bit, and try to make it so it's not just one and done when it comes to his striking attack. Liddell gets back up. Going orthodox now. St. Preux gets caught by the inside leg kick.
Oh! This could be it!
Oh, he might be out!
He's in trouble right now.
And now starting to snap off that jab. Out of range with that one.
Got him clinched up against the fence.
pummels here, and now he's got double underhooks.
Oh, nice takedown.
Slams him to the canvas with authority.
He's in half guard here with his opponent pressed up against the cage.
Less than 2 minutes now to go in round two.
Back up to his feet again.
How about that shin?
Right hand forward now, switching to southpaw.
So a much different approach for him here in this second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feel.
Oh, he clipped him! He's trying to hang on! Big shots!
And there he swung with a haymaker.
Nice jab!
Oh! Oh, big left!
This could be it right here.
All right, 45 seconds now to go in the round. That shot blocked by Chuck Liddell. Well, he walked into his opponent's range there and ate that hook. He was unprotected, unguarded, and he's been susceptible to that hook in previous UFC fights. Got to figure out a way to move those feet and ultimately circle out and get that head off the center line. Hook attempt now blocked, though, by the Iceman. And that's the end of round number two. All right, that's the end of the round. And our cameraman all over that cut on the cheek. That thing is getting wider by the minute and only getting...
Here we go,
left corner,
ready? Are you ready?
Third round underway.
That last round was absolutely insane. If this round gets off to anything like the last round, one of these guys is going out. I can't imagine a scenario where if they continue where they left off in the last round, that one of these guys doesn't get knocked out.
Well, just as he did in the previous round, he continues to connect on a high volume of strikes. And a good sign, too, doesn't seem to be slowing down whatsoever.
Oh, beautiful right hook.
See the total strikes.
Oh, big left hand! And another one, he's in trouble. Back to half guard now.
Well, just because you're on your back doesn't mean you can't throw offense. Staying busy here, you like to see that, Joe.
He's moved back to half guard. He's going for a choke here. The tight guillotine. That is a tight guillotine. Now he's pretty deep. Oh, that's nasty. He's free. That guillotine was close.
He's in half guard here.
Look at this. He's out of it. Oh, he got reversed. Excellent movement on the ground here. Always trying to better his position.
Well, he's in north-south now. Let's see if he can hold it.
Engaging in the clinch here, Joe.
They separate from the clinch.
Under 2 minutes now to go in the fight.
Dropping down, looking for a single.
The Iceman gets back up again. Just misses with the jab. Well, not sure if
he... Ow! He's very wobbly, he's trying to hang on. He is hurt.
Oh!
Body kick, look at that.
All right, we have reached the final minute of the fight. 1 minute remains in the fight.
He got tagged there.
Oh! Oh!
And just like that, the fight is over.
Oh, man! And here's the end of the fight. Let's take a look at that from a different angle.
Let's see that again. Ba-boom!
Well, what a moment for this fighter here tonight. A massive knockout on the sport's biggest stage. Seminal moment for that fighter tonight. We go right inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer. He has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 17 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Iceman, Chuck Liddell!
So there's the man of the moment, just the way he...